Hi there, my name is Demetri, and I am the man with a plan who's going to show you how we at Softr utilize the user tab and how you can utilize it as well. Actually, how anybody can use it. I'm not limiting the amount of people, that would be ridiculous. But by signing into any application, on the left-hand side here, if you see right here, we have the users tab. So clicking on that, you'll see that we have some example data right in here. In this video, we're gonna dive into not only what the users tab is, but also the different ways that you can import and add users into your Softr app. First of all, let's dive into how to add the different users. So as you can see on the top right here, we can add users. And this is something that you can manually do by typing out my name, Demetri. And then here we can put Demetri@softr.io. And there are two different options here that we can choose from. First, generate a temporary password. So by generating a temporary password, that would be what the person can log into the system with using the sign in and login blocks. They'll be sent this invite by email, or you can do generate magic link. What magic links do is they allow you to essentially click on the link and you'll then have access to that Softr app without needing to put in a password. First, we're gonna just do this generate temporary password option. So save and continue. And it ends up showing right here, the email and password options. So you can either finish without inviting or create the invite. By creating the invite, it'll send it to their email. So I'm gonna do create invite by pressing send invite. You can see right here that I have this example password. So if I click on this link, Demetri@softr.io, then go back here, copy this password, and then paste it in, check it out, and then sign in. And then bada bing, bada boom, I'm in there. Now getting in there is also possible, as I mentioned earlier, with magic links. If I press on this magic link right here, you'll see that it generates a random link. So by copying this and pasting it into a new tab, you'll see that I magically get authentication. I'm some sort of wizard to get in to this application. Now, once I'm logged into this application with that magic link, I actually can generate a new one or delete this one. So if I press delete right here, you'll see that if I refresh this and attempt to paste in this magic link again, oh no, I'm not cool enough to use that anymore because it doesn't exist. So if I press this plus icon again and copy it, it'll work. And then same thing, if I end up pressing this generate new link, try to paste that in again, it will not work. And I will need to use this new one that I can copy and paste it, and then boom, I'm in. Now, something you'll see right here is that I have this user's table already connected to Airtable. I'm gonna remove this connection and start from scratch. So if I press connect data source here, obviously you can put in your data source from your API key. In order to do that, you're gonna go to your Airtable, go to the top right, go to Developer Hub, and then make sure you copy the link that you'll see right here in the API key section, and then you'll end up pasting it in here. But since I already have mine, I can just select it, and then I'm going to pick the applicant tracking by Softr, and I'm gonna pick the table interviewers. Then you can select the email field, so email address, and then there are some optional additional fields. So I'm going to do name, and then I can create a magic link field by essentially creating a link in Airtable. So I go to interviewers, I can create a field and as a URL called magic link, press URL, create field. And then I'm gonna have to refresh here in order to get that field, but let's do it again. Applicant tracking by Softr. Select table, interviewers, email address, name, magic link, and then photo is what's gonna be my avatar field. Then press save. So as you see right here, when I refresh this, it ends up changing the magic link right here. Now you are able to actually import users via a CSV as well. If you think about it from this standpoint, this user data would be available in a CSV. So I can click on this and then press download CSV, and that would get this data out of here. Then I could bulk import by going to downloads, all of these interviewees, and then I just map the field. So name, email address, and then an optional password field. So if I wanted to add an extra password field, I could, as well as any other fields, and then press create invite. And I'm just gonna generate magic links, make it easier on myself. And then it would send the invite to them if I press this to their emails. And then boom, added all these different emails to the applicant tracking system. Now within Airtable, you can use a single select property in order to create different user roles. So if I go back into Airtable, I can add a new single select field, which is going to be, for example, a manager and just a general applicant. Now I can press color code options to make it easier. Click a different color, create field right here. Now press add user group in the user groups tab, type manager. And then here, we're gonna make sure that we do a condition where this is only visible if the logged in user has the role is, and then exactly what you want, manager. Then cross-reference this here. So for example, can change some people, different applicants versus managers. Or in this context, I can actually take it from manager to somebody who would be a general employee. So if I were to change this, edit field, employee, naturally I'm a manager, just look at me. And then logged in user role is manager, press create user group. Then after that, we could actually set it so that, you know, different people would by default go into different pages. So the manager, for example, could go to the applicant details by default. And then when they sign out, they can go to the home page. Whereas all users would just go to the home page after they sign in. It's all about separating it based off of the type of user group you're trying to segment. Then if we go to add user group, we can also do employee, then any match the following conditions, logged in user, role is employee, create user group. And then when they log in, we're just gonna see applicants. Then when they log out, see home. And then for example, say we wanted to, in the applicant details section, we can go to settings and then visibility and change it. So add user group, and it's only available to managers based on what we had in the user group section so that it prevents random employees from seeing the different applicant information. An applicant, for example, could be seen here by any employee, but they could not see the further details within here. So go to users area, check out, and paste this in here from the magic link. Since I'm a really cool manager, right? I can go to the applicants, see the Lane Bergman details by clicking on her. And then all of this will pop up so I get more context. But if I were to go back here, go to Andy, remember in Airtable, he's just an employee. So if I copy his link and log in as him, he, on the other hand, when clicking on this, would not be able to see it. Frowny face. And he can't see the details of any of these. So sad.
You know, there's something that I wanted to tell you. And it's about the fact that when I first recorded this video, there wasn't this amazing feature, but now it's here. When we work within users, all of the different things I mentioned before applied, but now there is a two-way sync. That's right. There's syncing between your Airtable and your Softr app. Both ways. Now when working in this system, you can see that there's a sync right here. So for example, if I go into my applicant tracking software, you can see that this is connected to interviewers. So if I go here and press refresh table, immediately you'll see how the sync works. With more data inside of Airtable, it immediately brought it into my software app. And then in the other direction, if I add the user, me, do Demetri at softr.io and then give myself a little magic link, I can save and continue. And as per usual, what will happen is that when I go back in here, it's going to sync the users from this direction and put it into Airtable. And if I wanted to, you can see right here that there is a non-named person. So if I go back into the system, I'm going to name this person Alan Dismail. Once this finishes syncing, it will show what I inputted into my Airtable account. If you're working in an app currently that doesn't have two-way sync, you're gonna get a notification that allows you to enable two-way sync, which makes this a significantly easier process. Just like what I did at the beginning of the video when I essentially pressed sync, it will allow you to retroactively turn two-way sync on and get away from that pesky one-way sync. This can be used with any data source that we have, not just Airtable. And it is just so nice that it does this now. Just like it's so nice that you are going to improve your Softr skills if you check out this video right here.